I, Danielle, take you, Zeus, to be my lawfully wedded financial supporter. I vow to stress you the fuck out and eat off your plate for the rest of our lives. I will go through your phone in sickness and in health and accuse you of cheating whether I have found proof or not. I promise to gain weight and let myself go until you no longer want to stick your inside of me. When times get rough between us, I will complain more and listen less, never pray about it, and make us both look stupid by airing all of our business on Facebook. And even though I got pregnant on purpose to trap you into marrying me, I still won't tell you about all the guys I let slip me out. I vow to love you for the rest of my life and never, ever leave you. As long as you don't lose your good-paying job with benefits, or I'll leave you for someone with good f***ing money. I love you.
Fellas, I'ma tell you a secret that you didn't know, you already knew. What do I mean by that? I'm about to make you aware of a deep subconscious truth that society has trained you to ignore. Women love pathological liars. But hear me out, I'm gonna prove it. But first, ask yourself this question. What is the mindset required for the average man to have a successful marriage in modern society? Doom, 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 doom. Give up? I tell you, the mindset of a pathological liar. The Christian religion is the foundation for the traditional American marriage. Whether you Christian or not, almost everyone gets married in a church, with a priest, under God. Statistically, women seek marriage to men that are financially viable, and most, if not all, of those women do not have their virginities intact. Knowing that fact, the men that marry them will tell the world that their wife was sent from God. Now riddle me this, Batman. Who sends a 304 to a trick for temporary love?
You live on the water player, but you can't make a thing, you dig?
But let that same woman divorce him, and her lawyers will let him know the truth of where she was really sent from. And if that man ever did ask God if his wife was truly sent from him, I'm sure God would say,
not this time. No, not this time. Not this time. Wrong. Not this time. Not this time. You're wrong. Not this time.
But I know why they thought she was sent from heaven, because that's exactly what they see. When she keeps going after you done busted all your shoelaces and shot all your shoestrings. The biggest liar in Western society is not the politicians, scam artists, or the media. It's the man married to the modern woman.
My wife had a past and I don't care.
Sure.
I don't care if Usher rubbed up against my wife's booty. Her dress was the only thing I was focused on.
Sure. I watch corn, but that's not cheating. Sure, because you married under Christian principles and lusting after another woman is perfectly fine, right? In fact, the number one consumer of the 304 industry is the modern married man. Damn near every Gen X and millennial child has found his dad's hidden jack mag stash. Hell, married men are the number one cheaters too, and they not good at it. They get caught cheating and get everything taken away like the teachers used to do back when we was in school. Women love being lied to. If you've been married to a modern woman for 10 years, then you've been lying every day for 10 years. You need more proof? Okay, let's just see what happens when the modern man tells the truth.
Babe, do you like my nails like this? Or do you think I need to make them longer?
Do you want the truth or the husband answer?
Why do you have to be such a smartass?
Do you want the truth? Or the husband answer.
I know you're gonna piss me off. give me the husband answer.
Looks amazing the way it is. Love it.
Thank you. Thank you. Give me the truth.
Don't give a f-
So me and you been in a relationship for some time now, and I just gotta ask, how do you know you love me?
You don't want the answer to that.
Yes, I do.
No, but like, you really don't. And you know I'm the type of person, I'm always gonna tell you the truth no matter what.
Right.
And you don't want the answer to that.
I want the honest, truthful answer to
that. No, I promise you, like, if I tell you the answer, we might break up.
I want the answer.
You sure? Like, are you sure? Like, I'm really giving you the chance to back out of this. Are you sure? 100% positive. This is what you want.
I am 100% sure I want the answer.
It's trash. And I didn't care. That's how I knew I really was in love with you.
Fellas, if you currently in a relationship and you know you got a lot to survive, then hit that like and subscribe. Unless you currently watching this video with your girl, then you better not hit that like. But baby girl, if y'all watching this and he don't hit that like, he lying. Get his ass. And I don't want to hear all you fake alphas in the comments talking about, oh yeah, I tell my girl the truth 100% of the time. That's a lie. Man, the only dudes that's telling they girls the truth is Grooboos Boo Boo, because they ain't got nothing to lose. Because who gives a screw over some Grooboo crying boo hoo because her boo boo then told her the truth? Grooboos Boo Boo don't count. You can't tell the truth to a Grooboo and expect dudes to give you yo dudes like you some kind of cool. No, you some kind of fool, and nobody's the Lulu, so screw you and your Grooboo. Married men don't just lie to everyone else, they lie to themselves. Have you seen those married couples that argue all the time and you try to eavesdrop but you get caught sometimes? A woman that will argue all day with a man that she chose to be her leader is disrespectful. It proves that she doesn't respect you or the way you think. A married man will ignore his conscience telling him this and will convince himself that it'll get better or that he can fix it. What about those wives at family functions belittling their husbands or telling jokes at their expense? What about those women that refuse to make their husbands a plate and get on other women that try to make their husbands a plate?
This man, because he can't fix his own plate?
Worry about you, ma'am.
Hey, oh, hey, 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 don't be going doing that with my sister. You can go on, my guy.
No,
I
don't
even
know this man. No, my guy.
You can get
up out
of here, my guy. You can go on, my guy. Go back to the streets.
Please. Like that. Well, I told you these folks don't really mess with me like that, bro.
Okay,
so
you
I
need to go
home.
Go home.
I don't know these folks, bro. I don't do that, bro.
Well, don't start. Let him go. Yeah.
He ain't gonna leave me here.
What are you doing, my family?
Say less, brother.
Say less. Oh. Get all y'all here, bro. All right. Bye.
What about the women you see on girls' trips or nurses? Or wives of men in the military? What about these basketball wives? Or when an average chick marries a celebrity? You don't think those men are not constantly telling themselves a lie? I don't care if you broke at McDonald's or you rich and ballin'. The biggest lie that married men tell themselves is their queen has not fallen.
I'm her side dude. Of course we f*** raw. We love each other. I'm her side dude. Of course I come over when you go to work. You work every day. I'm her side dude. Of course I want y'all to stay together. Who else money we gonna spend? I'm her side dude. Of course my number is saved as Fashion Nova. I send all the promotions. I'm her side dude. Of course we met at her job. She don't go nowhere else. I'm her side dude. Of course our dates are out west bumba fuck so we don't run into you or your peoples. I'm her side dude. Of course your second child don't look like you. That's my baby. I'm her side dude. Getting head is a part of. I'm her side dude. Of course our homegirls cover for us when we out. I'm her side dude. Of course we have sex when she on her period. She told me you don't do it. Now we got a soul tie. She's never getting rid of me. I'm her side dude. Of course we call to see how far away you are. I'm her side dude. Of course I coach her on how to gaslight you into thinking nothing's going on. I'm her side dude. Of course if you catch us together, I'ma act gay. I'm her side dude. Of course we got married at work. We didn't jump the broom, we jumped the stapler. I'm her side dude. Of course I fake like I want y'all to break up and we can be together. That's a part of the fantasy. I'm her side dude. Of course she has to work late on February 15th. That's my day.
Statistically, 35% of men are raising children that they don't know are not theirs. We all have that married friend that truly believes that the kitty he's smashing won't bite him in the balls.
I wrote her in today because I'm telling you she's a better person.
Another reason the world laughs at a man married to the modern woman is because some of them are forced to tell lies that not even they believe. Lies about how happy they are.
Guys, if you want a healthy relationship, it's all about the small things, yeah? Like that. Guys, I got about 3 seconds, yeah?
Don't get married, don't get relationship. They're gonna fuck your life and they're gonna take all your money.
Why did you stop there?
Oh, I just to check my tire pressure.
How attracted to their wife they are. Father, I'm coming home. How they would never look at another woman.
Lord have mercy. We must stay focused, brothers. We must stay focused.
And they lie about how much they enjoy their wives' endless gossip and banter after asking an innocent yet simple question like, how was your day?
How was your day? It's good. I woke up and went to work. I'm a manager. She's such a bitch. Lunchtime. Iced lemon tea. It was so good. I saw this dress online. It was so pretty. Yeah, today was actually quite good. Oh, did you see the Blackpink concert? Did you like it? I think today was actually quite good.
There are millionaires and there are happy marriages. But you have a better chance of becoming a millionaire than keeping the woman you with. The modern woman have men trained better than military drill sergeants. And this next clip perfectly personifies your likelihood to survive in that environment. My parents are married and going on strong somewhere in the ballpark of 50 years. My uncle on my dad's side that just passed before last Christmas was married to my aunt for over 80 years. And don't get it twisted, when my mom married my dad, she had all the freedoms to be independent like women have today. So why do I believe that those marriages lasted and the modern ones don't? 304 culture, the lack of shame, the fall of Christianity, social media, effinism, and the number one reason more destructive than all of those combined, the simp. There's no need for strong women unless there's an abundance of weak men. And this is what those weak men would look like if they were forced to tell the truth.
Zeus, take you, Danielle, to be the biggest fucking mistake I've ever made. With this ring that your ass didn't earn, I plan to forever go in debt. Baby, as I stare at you in this beautiful white dress, all I can think about are all the bad bitches I'm gonna miss out on because of you. I promise to snore loud and take all the covers, piss on the seat, wall, and floor in the bathroom, and pretend to listen to you when you talk to me about that I don't care about. As your lawfully wedded husband, I promise to put up with your crazy ass as best as I can without shaking the shit out of you. I promise to hide as many naked pictures in my phone as possible, and put up with your broke-ass relatives and friends when they stop by our house and eat all our food. And finally, baby, you are my world. And as I stand here pretending not to regret the shit out of this decision, I can't help but to think about all my family and friends that told me, keep your heart, Three Stacks. Keep your heart. Hey, keep your heart, Three Stacks. Keep your heart. Nothing would make me happier in this world than to make love to the same woman and suck on the same long, ashy-ass, goldfish bag-filled for the rest of my life. Or until our child is old enough to understand the concept of divorce, and then shit, I'm out. I love you. Kinda.
Well, I now pronounce you an unhappily married.
But anyway, man, that's the video for today. And if you enjoyed the video, be sure to like the damn video. Be sure to click here to see why women never really get over their toxic exes in America. If you're missing my shorts, be sure to hit me up on Instagram at NGE_nevergoodenough. And if you want to do some business with me, be sure to hit me up on my email at NGENevergoodenough@gmail.com. And remember, become the change you want to see. It's your boy, NGE. Peace.